aptly named after the myriad of birds that hover over the gentle waters of the craters. The Balinsasayao Twin Lakes Natural Park offers a mesmerizing view that deserves more than just a memorable snapshot. Beyond the usual facts and stats that forest guides share, it is also interesting to listen to the stories exchanged by people along the trail. Up close and personal with wild vanishing species, experts believe that this park is a fragile sanctuary that deserves nothing less than a sustainable program for protection and conservation. The province of Negros Oriental, west of Dumaguete, is home to the Balinsasayao Twin Lakes Natural Park. Generally mountainous in topography, its most prominent features are the twin crater lakes separated by a narrow mountain ridge. The twin lakes are Lake Balinsasayao and Lake Danao.
Lake Balinsasayao, yung una, yung lawak po niya ay 76 hectares po, ay ang deep po naman niya ay 97 meters po. Yung Lake Danao naman po, so ang lawak naman po niya ay 30.5 hectares. Tapos ang deep naman po niya ay 55 to 58 meters po.
The Twin Lakes and their surrounding forests serve as a critical watershed for the province, as it contains the headwaters of five major rivers that sustain agriculture in lowland communities.
Diyan kumukuha ng inumin tubig yung tatlong municipality po natin, San Jose, Valencia, pati na yung Sibulan, at saka yung Dumaguete din. Kasi yung water table, pag hindi intact yung forest dito, kapalagay ko sigurong wala silang makukuha na fresh water doon sa baba. Kasi nasa mataas tayo.
At the turn of the millennium, in year 2000, the Balinsasayao Twin Lakes Natural Park was proclaimed a protected area by former President Joseph Estrada through Proclamation Number 414. With the passage of the expanded National Integrated Protected Area System, or INIPAS Act of 2018, on June 22, 2018, Balinsasayao Twin Lakes Natural Park is one of the 94 protected areas legislated by Congress. Efforts to conserve the wildlife in the park have inspired stakeholders to identify and protect the threatened species, including the 27 species of mammals, 49 species of herpetofauna, and 114 species of birds in the area.
There are important species of fauna and flora that can be found in our area. So for fauna, we have the large flying fox, we have the Negros striped babbler, we have the Visayan wrinkled-billed hornbill. We have the Negros bleeding heart pigeon. We have the hazel frogs and 27 mammals.
The park is an important bird area where threatened species of birds have been sighted. Identified terrestrial flora within the park revealed 237 plant species and some 124 fern species, many of which are globally threatened.
For flora, we have the red lawaan, white lawaan, tangili, giho, almasiga, and many more. Then, aside from that, we are also adjacent to the Cuernos de Negros, which is a key biodiversity area. One of the ecotourism products here is bird watching. boating because of the lake, kayaking. We have also variety of fern species. That is why we have fernery garden near the restaurant. We can offer also outdoor photography because of the beauty of the park.
Kami po yung katuwang ng DENR po na papatupad po namin yung mga policies po, yung mga pagprotektar po sa kalikasan po natin. Before po ay kami yung mga illegalista po dito. Kami yung mga guides po ng mga hunters. At saka yung hanap buhay namin dati ay putol kami ng mga puno, ibinta namin sa talyer para po ay makakuha kami ng mga pangkabuhayan po, pagkain po sa loob ng pamilya po. Yun yung unang trabaho namin dito. Nung nahuli kami, so pinadala kami doon sa Dumaguete. So yun pala, akala namin ikukulong na kami, ay trainings pala yun. Una naming naka-attend kami ng trainings, nagbigay kasi yung Foundation for the Philippine Environment ng funding doon na mag-conduct po ng trainings tungkol dito po sa environment po natin.
The attitude of Rico and the rest of his members were gradually transformed, no? From being our enemy in the forest, because they are destructing our forest, they are the one responsible for cultivation, kaingin, illegal hunting. They gradually transformed into our partner, no, in development and protection of the natural resources that we have here in the area. We provide them training, no, training, of course, support in terms of development and maintenance of ecotourism facilities. Like what we have here now, we have the viewing deck, we have the lookout tower, we have the parking area, we have the information center, we have the administration building. So we have also the wharf, no? The wharf is being used by bar of PO as the parking area of their double body boat and kayaks. And of course, one of the challenges is how to retain our trained and experienced personnel if they will not be given a permanent position, no? We keep on hiring new personnel because our trained staff, of course, they are looking for a greener pasture, no, for the future. So of course, if they will be accommodated in other offices, of course they will transfer to other offices. So that's the challenge that we should address. Because mahirap mag-train, palaging mag-train ng mga staff in order to manage effectively the park.
Over the years, management of the park's land resources has been focused on the areas classified under the multiple use zone. Here is where traditional settlements and use of the land such as agroforestry, livelihood, recreation, and most ecotourism activities are conducted.
Based on the recent assessment conducted in our park, number one threat is the illegal occupation inside the park. Some are cultivating the park for abaca plantation.
Nung sinabi kasi na naging sakop na ito ng NIPAS Act, yung problema namin dito kasi yung sinabing Pak Barma, yung protected area management agreement ng park, ay hindi pa naibigay hanggang ngayon. Ang malaking tulong sa amin po ay nung may agreement kami sa provincial government dati na yung boating activity at yung restaurant po ay binigay sa amin, yun yung mga malaking tulong na naibigay sa asosasyon po namin. Saka yung mga member din po namin, nagkakaroon na po sila ng SSS. Ang yung kahilingan po namin ay yung tenured migrant agreement po na maibigay na po sa amin.
Expectedly, only the consistent and collaborative relationships between and among stakeholders can help confront these challenges.
Una, yung mga existing laws na bawal yung pagputol ng kahoy, hanggat maaari Zero yung ano eh, cutting of trees in Negros Oriental.
Another threat is the landslide. This is a landslide prone area because of the elevation. And also poaching of wildlife.
Laki ang tulong natin kasi una, to protect the people who are in the field, eh, kailangan ng LGU yan eh. Para maglakas loob sila na talagang in-increase ko yung bantay lasang. Number of bantay lasang sa akin is na mas lalong dumami. Number two, support livelihood program of the people living in that area. Number three, support infrastructure projects.
Dandahan na rin nating linapitan ang local government units at dandahan natin silang na-convince. In fact, the local government of Sibulan has recently allocated 50,000. Initial lang yan para magamit natin for the management of the park. Isa sa mga activity namin yun sa law enforcement plan is dapat mayroon tayong drone. Kasi nakita namin mas effective yung monitoring pag gumamit tayo ng drone kaysa mag-hire tayo ng maraming bantay lasang. So ang LGU Balinsa nakabili na ng drone at sabi ni Mayor, pwede namin hiramin yung drone for the monitoring of all activities inside the park.
When you come to Lake Balinsasayao, talagang maiinganyo kayo, babalik ng babalik. Kasi it's really a nice place. It's really a good place. Talagang untouched, you know. Talagang maganda yung pagka-manage na ng PAMBI, ng local government, ang cooperation with the people. Talagang na-protected talaga yung areas. We can only do so much. We need the support of everybody. Kung isang tao magtanim lang ng isang kahoy, for 100 million people in the Philippines, we will be having 100 million trees for next year. That's very, very, very positive insofar as recovery of our ecosystem is concerned.
With more birds hovering over the Twin Lakes, more visitors learning about environmental protection of the park every single day, there is great hope for conservation to be sustained in this nature's jewel in Negros Oriental. Truly, in the hands of intelligent stakeholders lies the preserved and protected beauty of the Balinsasayao Twin Lakes Natural Park. It is impossible not to be captivated by the imposing beauty of Mount Kanlaon. Its stature and vastness are accentuated by the lush landscape that surrounds it. A sense of romance and mysticism also enfolds the mountain, sustained by the legends that were born out of its magnificence. Standing majestic at 2,435 meters, this active volcano is the tallest peak not just on the island of Negros, but all over the Visayas. It is the heart of one of the country's centers of biodiversity. While the volcano is undoubtedly the centerpiece of the island's natural attractions, its surroundings are integral to the area's ecosystem. Over decades, thousands of mountaineers and explorers have come to discover the wonders of the Mount Kanlaon Natural Park, either to commune with nature or study the wildlife found in its pristine forests and water courses. The 24,388-hectare park is located in the heart of Negros Island. Straddling Negros Occidental and Negros Oriental provinces and encompassing the cities of Bago, La Carlota, San Carlos, and Kanlaon, as well as the municipalities of Murcia, La Castellana, the park serves as a vital watershed that feeds into many rivers and streams of the island, which in turn provides sufficient water supply to lowland communities for domestic, agricultural, and commercial consumption.
This is one of the protected areas in Negros Occidental, of which ito yung protected area na has been declared as a national park. And mayroon siyang sariling law, yung RA 9154 that was acted in 2001, declaring that area as a protected area under the category of natural park. So the purpose of not natural park, this is not only intended for that purpose of watershed, but at the same time, ito yung isa sa mga primary destinations when it comes to sustainable development and of course, biodiversity conservation program of the DENR. MKNP is home to various flora and fauna, endemic species. Makita natin na intact pa yung forest cover, a portion of that protected area that serves as the watershed. At the same time, ito yung mga habitat na mayroon tayong mga different species of fauna.
Dito sa Mount Kanlaon, no, ito yung makikita natin yung Philippine Dipterocarp Forest. No? Yung White Lawaan, Red Lawaan, Tanggili, Almasiga, Bagtikan, at marami pa ibang mga Dipterocarp species. In terms naman sa fauna, yung the bleeding heart pigeon ng Western Visayas ay dito lang makikita sa Mount Kanlaon. Yung Tarictic Hornbill, may dito rin kami. Yung mga ibang-ibang mga bird species. No? Almost 159 species of birds ang makikita dito sa Mount Kanlaon. No? And almost 179 species of fauna ang nandito.
The variety of wildlife in the park, some are rare and considered threatened species, undoubtedly attracts visitors to the area. Ecotourism is gaining momentum at Mount Kanlaon Natural Park. Local and foreign adventure tourists journey to Negros for its renowned trekking destinations. The trails offer diverse natural attractions, including agricultural land, rainforest, waterfalls, lagoons, and rock formations near the volcano crater. Although the bounties of Mount Kanlaon Natural Park offer opportunities, there are also threats to its rich ecosystem. Natural hazards such as the imminent yet unpredictable eruption of the volcano and even typhoons are beyond anyone's control. Human activities also pose long-term adverse effects. Habitation or incursion in the protected area should also be checked.
Yung isang threat na nakita natin, no, the presence of settlement areas sa loob ng park. No? Mayroon tayong 15 barangay sa loob ng park. No? So yung community are using the resource sa loob ng park. No? Nagiging pressure ito sa atin na natural resources sa loob. No? So the other one is yung pagrami ng population, no, ng mga community doon. Kung hindi natin makontrol yung community sa loob, yung population nila, so rarami at rarami yung mga tao. Baka yung resource natin mauubos kung hindi natin makontrol. Because of that population, yung basura sa loob, no, kailangan natin i-manage. The conversion of forest land into other land use, like for example, yung mga farmlands, pag-widen ng mga farmlands sa loob ng parke, isa yung threats, no, na nakita natin at kailangan bantayan. No.
Sustainable development does not only mean for the environment, but of course, we have to manage people that are also truly dependent on natural resources. Especially that Mount Kanlaon Park has two zonifications, the strict protection zone and of course the multiple use zone. So these zones has its own prescriptions. So in the strict prescriptions, these are
the lineup activities considered to be allowed and of course not allowed activities. And it has been approved by the Protected Area Management Board, the governing body of the protected area.
Enforcement of laws and regulations, disaster preparedness, as well as implementation of policies has become a shared responsibility among the stakeholders. This include the DNR, the PAMBI, the local government units, members of the communities themselves, including the indigenous people living in the highlands of the park. The community's active involvement is vital to the sustainability efforts of both the national and local governments. They have become valuable partners in sustainable development and may be seen less as threats to conservation. One successful community-based program is a Kanlaon Green Brigade.
Yung KGB naman, Kanlaon Green Brigade, yung function namin dito, bali nag-stop ng mga illegal logging, illegal trekking, tsaka nagmo-monitor kami dito ng mga kung anong mga activities ng mga taga rito rin at saka mga visitor mismo. Na nung una wala yung KGB dito. Marami din dito na mga illegal kagaya din namin at saka ako mismo. Hunter ako ma'am ng mga ibon, mga hayop dito na mga kahit anong mga hayop diyan sa taas. At saka kumukuha din ako ng ratan na binibinta sa Legarda na para pang hanap buhay din namin, para may makain. Nung pumasok yung DNR, in-educate kami na bawal yung mag-ganyan, ganito. Kaya kami parang sinabi naman namin sa amin sarili na makabalang araw mawawala yung mga hayop dyan at saka yung mga punong kahoy. Mga dapat na gawin, seminar kami ng LGU, ng DENR. Doon na laman namin na bawal at saka doon kami na pumasok sa KGB. Nabuti na lang may mga hanap buhay din dito na gaya ng guide at saka yung mga magka-flower. At saka mga homestay, at saka mayroon din dito na mga manok ma'am, nakatulong din sa amin yung manok. Nandyan ako sa office ng sa station ranger, may mga bisita, pinalalagbok ko, at saka in-interview ko rin, kung, at saka sinasabihan ko, ganitong bawal, kukuha kayo ng guide. Ini-explain ko sa kanila kung ano ang mga roles ng PAMBI dito na nagpapangsyon ngayon dito.
Working with people's organizations is also an effective way to educate the locals and encourage them to participate in environmental programs.
Association namin ang Amnig sa Kinayan organization, part sa components ang sa aming kwan ng program is to we have a protection and law enforcement with coordinated sa ating office of the PASO. So we are volunteers, we have no salary because of our objective ng association namin is to help, contribute, protect Mountain Laon from destruction. Sa ngayon, 36 ka-member ang Kanlaon Green Brigade. Kahit paano, iniisip lang namin sa level namin kung paano kami makatulong. Nag-award din sa amin ng project ng National Greening Program para rin in return maka-income rin ang mga member ko mismo dito na nakatira. Tapos mas kansa kasi, mas effective sa kasi kung community-based. Kasi alam mo lahat ang nangyayari sa paligid. So madali lang namin ma-monitor kung mayroon talagang may illegal nga nangyayari sa loob.
The park's participatory development includes respecting the rights of its original inhabitants called the Bukidnon. These indigenous people have called the mountain their home for centuries, and their traditional knowledge on nature has sustained them for many years.
Yun sa mga puno at mga bulaklak ng mga makikita natin ito sa bundok na to ng Mountain Laon ay may connection sa aming buhay. Kasi yung sa aming sariling tingin po ay yung mga bulaklak na bumubukadkad siya parang may masama na panahon na naparating. Meron kaming mga gamot na nanggaling sa mga puno at sa kabayan nito na makikita lang natin yun sa bundok ng Mountain Laon.
Various programs of the national government, such as the National Greening Program, engage them in reforestation while providing alternative livelihood opportunities. While they appreciate these efforts, the Bukidnon also appeal for the continued prohibition of industries in the protected area.
Yun lang ang paliwanag namin sa lahat na ahensya ng gobyerno na hindi po pwede pumapasok ang kahit sino man na mga kumpanya para magmimina. Kay lahat yung mga puno, lahat yung mga halaman ay mahalaga para sa aming kabuhayan.
There is a strong spiritual connection between the people and Mount Kanlaon, a silent, unifying force that pushes them to bravely explore and uncover its beauty while ensuring the protection and sustainable development of its bounty for future generations.